they are the dinosaurs. Long ago, before many things we now know, before cities, towns, and roads, before people, before birds, frogs, and toads. Long, long, long before, it was the day of the dinosaur. Others fat, some were big. Very, very, very big. They tell us Tyrannosaurus Rex was huge and fierce and strong, with terrible quick jaws and teeth 6 inches long. Its ferocity was famous. It has long been told of. What did the Tyrannosaurus eat? Whatever it got hold of. But sometimes Tyrannosaurus bit off more than it could chew. Then the armored Stegosaurus was pretty mighty too. Its back were armor plated. Its tail was tipped with the spikes. It's not very reckless not to duck when a Stegosaurus strikes. Brachiosaurus's nostrils were atop its head. They let it breathe while sleeping in its water bed. Dimetrodon was a carnivore, which means food with meat. Its great and splendid back snail was used to take in heat. The creature Pteranodon had a 20-foot wingspan. It was the biggest flyer ever since the Earth began. It had a 4-foot bill and a very softly crest. When it comes to flying reptiles, it was the biggest and the best. Archaeopteryx is not an easy word, but neither was it easy beginning Earth's first bird. After dinosaurs came other kinds of creatures. They also had amazing body parts and features. The saber-toothed tiger, of course, had saber teeth. The prehistoric rhino had rows of horns above and giant tusks below. The moa was a flightless bird. It stood 13 feet tall. It had gigantic drumsticks, but its brain was very small. The flightless moa is now extinct. In other words, there are no moa. But it no longer is the day of the dinosaur, except as fossil bones exist no more. They are now extinct. Sometimes we wonder why. Were there just too many for the food supply? Was there a great disaster? Or did it get too dry? Yeah. It's the sort of question question scientists are likely to think about. Maybe you'll be a scientist, and maybe you'll be the one to figure it out. Yeah, bye.